Hi there, welcome to my second match in the Blue Envelope Podcast League. Today I'm against Joe Fletcher. Frontman and drummer of the metal band Esoteric. That's probably what you can hear right now. Hopefully. Please don't delete this video, YouTube. I have his permission. Go and check him out on YouTube. Esoteric, this song's called Circle. It's 20 minutes of this. Ooh, goose. The deck I'm playing is the deck that Autumn Burchett has registered for the Mythic Championship because I am a dirty net decker, I don't play standard, and the deck I played last round was crap. Autumn's also just a really good player, so I trust them. Specifically a good metagamer as well. I think Autumn's known for just turning up with the best deck. If you've not seen it before, basically you play some lands. The lands make zombies. Zombies attack. You win. This is the five colour fires deck. So it's fires of invention is the difference to what you'd normally get in a Golos deck. Golos is always five. But basically you play the enchantment, so you can play two spells a turn, 4/3, why do they have land buffs left and the land so you can equal to the left and the control. I think it's got a good matchup against blue green. Joker's hard, I think this is Joker's hard. Whoever that is, he's got some on you. I will put on you. Boo! There is no justice in the world. Red, I guess, in case I draw the fires. The idea is that you sort of go. The ideal path of turns is turn 2, Growth Spiral, play third land, turn 4, fires into 3 security through, then you've got big lands, turn 4, play your 7th land, get a zombie, go mental, basically, you get 2 free spells. This game, as you can see, has not quite gone to plan. But you never know. Oko's pretty good at stealing Golos. I need to be careful with that. Go. Okay, well, that's not too bad. That's pretty good. They try to choose all the different things. He's playing main deck stage on stroke. That's GG. Not GG, I'm still in this. Yeah, the blue green decks have somewhat adapted to defeating Golos by playing that main deck stage on stroke. Oops. This is a hell of a card. I don't probably lose in this game. If I draw another Field of the Dead next turn, I might be fine because I'm just making 8 zombies. But that's provided he doesn't have another tick, so it's just aim for stroke. Guess I'll stay alive. Try to stay alive. Give it a priority. Yeah, GG. Fun game. I guess that's what you get when you play Golos. This is the bit where I don't know how to sideboard, but luckily this deck has a wishboard. Is Time Wipe any good? I guess blue-green. Probably not. That is pretty good. Sweet talk. Things. Nothing else really needs to come in. Definitely not that. Not a black and red deck. Nah, what's wrong with this? Let's see what you got, Fletch. Yeah, I don't know how indicative that first game was in this matchup, because obviously Commander Scrooge, you don't want to be playing your first Growth Spiral on turn 3 and your first Security Tree on turn 4. That is not the ideal turn of events. So let's try again. This hand is pretty pat. But I'll keep it. Oh, that's a good draw. Goose. Sure. Pick two life, so I can Growth Spiral. I don't think there's any reason to draw my turn. It's not like I'm going to surprise him, but I don't think he's playing two mana counter spells. I can target Growth Spiral. Or am I wrong? No. Yeah, we'll be keeping up to stay in a straight manner. So, I'm going to play three drops. Choose your spell permanent. Its owner puts it on top or bottom of their library. I'll put it on top. Decline. I want to. This is the most confusingly worded card. Decline to go on the bottom, I guess. If I don't want it, I'll draw a land next turn. Choose target spell or permanent that's red or green. Its owner puts it on top or bottom. Yeah, so the owner chooses, but it's really not obvious from the wording. Dragon. Okay, well that'll work. Go on, probably try and find out what's in my ball actually. Counter this. Doesn't really want to. I don't know. Not bad, not bad. Second crisis? I don't know. Okay. I guess the question is, do I draw two, maybe draw a Field of the Dead, then get two zombies out of it potentially, or do I just draw three? And I think I just draw three. I don't need to make those two zombies right now, so let's find the land. Dare ya. either gust mean? Autumn budget, Gorilla's fires, sideboard, what can I wish for? Agent checks we don't need, timeline don't need, defensive drake, sure, whatever. Look for bonus dragon ball, that would be fun to win with that. Lightning crew, yeah. Kill them again. Rewarded. Play Nicko Bolas next turn as well, I think. Can I? No, it costs triple black. Forget that. Got less swamps in the deck. So yeah, I'll play that for a while. Probably just how's that attack my land? Badly. Guess I'll do this one and see what happens. Note that leaves me with only single blue. Well, that's unfortunate. I should have got an island there. Even when I said it didn't matter. And if I don't draw anything, I could just make the giant. I mean, something probably getting counterspelled either way. Okay, well, that's a good point. Yeah, I think I'd want to try this giant. For us on the counter, we've got a bit of a blocking buffer now, so don't really care if it gets countered. I don't think it gets countered anyway. Feel like I'll struggle to lose this, but I always seem to be able to lose, whereas otherwise impossible. Oh, sure, I guess my giant's gonna get brutal. Yeah, litified. Okay, one card left in hand. So, probably can't spell, so I guess I'll draw it out with a pair of bushes, maybe? I can't block that. So maybe let's force the food sacrifice. Oh, that's a good draw. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I think what I'll do is cycle this, not cycle it, adventure it. Go on an adventure. Find an island. And then try an agent of treachery. I'll probably take the questing beast so I can then smash stuff at Oko. But it's probably getting countered. No. Okay then. And then that can come at you because it's got one of its 4 million abilities. Says deals damage to planeswalkers as well as creatures. That can attack Oko. How are we doing on Esoteric the Circle? Oh, it's 6 minutes of this song still to go, so I hope you're enjoying it. Let's have a little bit of a mellow moment, a bit of a chilled moment. Just before I assume it ramps up again. Just picture, I'm picturing my opponent, you know, mentally playing this in his mind as we play. The real war chant. Yeah, that's fine. Have some food. Who cares? I don't. It's fine. I feel like at this point can't really lose. Famous last words. I should have actually played this last turn, I think. Because Casualties of War is one of my things to play from top sideboard. And I don't have any swamps on my deck. But let's see. Let's see what I want. Oh, no. I want to wish. Let's tap my swamp as well, handily. Would a Teferi be any good? Probably would, actually. Artifact creature enchantment. That would make way for the creatures to come through if I bounce a land, maybe. Playing White Celebration is pretty good as well. Yeah, I'll make a Teferi. Can't go wrong with a Teferi, I like drawing cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I can't really balance my Agent of Treachery, sadly. So I think I'll just do this. Teferi quite handily locks my opponent out of making instant speed plays, obviously. That's gonna go there, he's gonna go there. I haven't counted, but I think that's a little. Pressing Beast runs into Gilded Goose, and the most wicked boy that there is eat one of those, and yeah, this is gonna die. Perfect. And then next turn, I'll probably win. Because I can wish for Time Warp, what's it called? Chance of Glory. And I'll probably have enough monsters to do lethal. Growth Wild first in case I hit another thing on the deck. Which is quite likely at this point. I've only got 1 in 10. 34 cards left, 3 in the deck. Crested Beast is lethal. Oh, it is a problem because it kills Teferi. No. Basics left in the deck. Don't care. Tepper's gonna die. So, yeah, this is definitely needed. We don't want to do that. Yes. I think I just do the Chance of Glory now. Oh no, they just tap my head. Creature control gets dropped as well. Take next turn for this one at the beginning. Yeah, and then if he doesn't counter it, then I think I just win. I haven't actually done the math, but. Sadly, don't quite have enough. Let me just double check. don't think I have any more basics.
No.
So I sadly don't quite have enough to do this, to play the giant, but hopefully the Fae will be enough to keep me going, see me through the night. Yeah, this has to be lethal. Surely. Let's check if I have any destruction effects. Sorry, direct damage effects in my... No, I don't know. So 1, 2. So that's 1, 2, 4. So that 10, 11, 12. Yeah, it's more than lethal. All attack. Sure, that takes you to 7. You need to gain 5 more. You're not going to. Woohoo! Got a game. Got a game. Let's do this. I don't seem drawing any of the actual keystones of the deck at the moment, like fires or golos, which may or may not be a problem. But yeah, I don't think whether or not our sideboard has changed at all. I feel like Kenrith probably. I don't know why this isn't a deck. It feels like it should be a wish target rather than a. What am I trying to say? Rather than a main deck card. So maybe I should. I could play this. I'm on the draw. Yeah. Fine. I feel like that's a good play. Without reading Autumn Sideboard knows I don't really know what I'm supposed to do, but there you go. Oh, that's a bad hand.
Is that bad?
Yeah, it's pretty bad. That's not great, but something does a trick. I don't need two of those really. You don't want to beat me, I don't know if you heard that. My computer telling me I've got a calendar invitation at 9 a.m. tomorrow. Does it matter which one I play? Yeah, this one, because then if I draw Growth Spiral, I can play it. Okay, that's promising. Sadly, no Great Spiral. That's not promising. Quite the opposite. I guess I'll do nothing now, and then if I need to, I can chain Clarion into Timewipe and see how that goes. Probably could have played that fairy actually. Yeah, I think playing the Fae of Wishes was the correct play there. Sadly. Come on, Nissa, and then yes, and then. Don't have. Oh no, Edith Gust doesn't do it. Yeah. So I don't think you can counter the Clarion now. Right. Fingers crossed. Three damage to each creature. Wee. I mean, there's still a Nissa to deal with, but less of a problem than it could have been. Fine. dangerous ground there, Joe. You're on dangerous ground. Okay, so I think I want to find a land, because I don't really want to draw a land. Doesn't matter which one. I said no last time than it did. I don't have two planes, so I probably want to get planes, so I can actually cast my time wipe. Okay, so I think I actually probably want to start with the Hydroid Crisis. I can probably get away with casting for two and then playing that Field of the Dead. So all the Hydroid Crisis really needs to do is, I think, threaten this as ultimate. Okay, so he does have something, Disdainful Stroke. Okay, that's fine. So Jesse's got more than one Disdainful Stroke. But I think I just have to assume no, because I'm just dead if he does have it. What are you tapping for? No, it's not fine, I'm dead. Oh, I'm dead. It's going to take six this turn. Wicked Wolf is going to survive Time Wipe. And then Nissa makes another one. Yeah, Nissa's still a hell of a card. Yeah, I'm dead. I just need to hope he forgets to activate Wicked Wolf, I think. Cross. Okay, anyway, a good game.